Barcelona go to Blue Ribbon?
Yeah, I'll do that. Emma's now panicking downstairs because she thinks Josh hasn't turned up. She's not realizing.
So, is somebody going to sing Danny Boy?
No.
Not this part of the day, I think.
Where's Lisa? Where's Lisa?
She'll come in.
They bring her in for the wedding party. Mm-hmm.
Gentlemen, please be upstanding for the bridal party. Take a seat and we'll begin our ceremony. firstly, can we formally thank you once more for coming along to the wedding celebration of Emma and Josh. It is with great delight that they asked me to officiate here. I am not a minister. I don't know, do this normally, so if I do stumble occasionally, please bear with me. But I'm sure everybody as a starting point will agree that this is probably one of the nicest events that can be in any family circle, with a wedding, and it's a joyous celebration of love. And it gives everybody a chance to sort of celebrate a future life together. And in this case, it's the future life of Emma and Josh. So before we touch on that and we get into the depth of the celebration part, there's a few things we should point out. Not only are we all together in this room, but we are linked up across the internet to the US, Canada, and India. And for those that don't know, that means we may speak a little bit more slowly than normal. That said, I think it's important we touch on a few things, you know, that are important. So, if any numpties are on Facebook, by the way, right, just there's no chance that you're going to post it right away. Did you get that, Ashley? For that joke there, it's for Ashley's benefit. Ashley's struggling with the Glaswegian accent. But it is genuinely a nice day to be here. Josh and Emma officially got married 49 days ago, on the 25th of April. I'm sure everybody remembers where they were on that day. Well, I know you two do. And I think it's really important that you actually try and cast your mind back to the times when, if you're in a relationship or you've been married, that first time you come together is also a memorable day. And that day in this instance occurred 11 years ago, the 9th of June 2003 was when Emma met Josh. And when you think about that, there's one thing sprung to my mind. What the hell were they doing out on a Monday night? Young people, eh? Anyway, it's a great honour to have everybody here. And as you see, our American friends are wearing the kilt as well. I have highlighted to Josh that actually it's only a kilt when a Scotsman wears it, and it's actually a skirt when someone else wears it.
You're not from Scotland.
Good point. We'll let you off with that one. So just before that, we move on a little bit further, you know, these two, a lot in common. Josh originally from Sandy Springs, Emma from Campus Lyon. Well, a train station, at least. Train station, that's about it. A loving couple, and I'm sure everybody will acknowledge this later. So, just before we move on a little bit further, I reflected on sort of what it was that brought people together in terms of love and faith, and what brings people together. And a lot of people say it's their star sign. So, I looked at Emma's star sign, Sagittarius, and seen who that was perfectly matched to. And believe it or not, it is actually matched to a Leo or an Aries. Leo DiCaprio wasn't available, so she settled for an Aries. I think that's what you'll find. But it's a really nice session here that we're going to have today in terms of the ceremony. And it's pretty certain there might be a wee party afterwards, so I think we'll enjoy that. I'm now going to ask Auntie Anne to come up and actually give us a nice reading, which will start the service.
Sun danced in the snow with a glittering smile, and two lovers sat quietly, alone for a while. Then he turned and he said with a casual air, though he blushed from his toes to the tips of his hair, "I think I'd quite like to get married to you." "Well then," she said, "well, there's a thought. But what if we can't be all that we ought? Can you promise me, say, you won't grumble or shout if I'm late yet again when we plan to go out?" but I know I can't see, but I'll learn to ignore dirty socks and damp towels strewn all over the floor. So if we can't promise to be all that we could, I'm not sure what to do, though the idea's quite good. But he gently smiled and tilted his head till his lips met his ears. Then softly he said, I promise to weave my dreams into your own. That whatever you breathe shall be my heart's hope. Your smile, I promise that whether with rags or with gold I'm blessed, your smile is a jewel I shall treasure best. Do you think then, my love, you should marry, do you? Yes, she said, smiling. I do.
Thank you very much, Anne. That was lovely. CDs and other tour merchandise will be available at the rear of the hall. We're now getting to something which is quite an important part of the ceremony. I should emphasise that Josh and Emma are married already. So there's no chance to object. That's gone. That's in the script. They're married. You have to get on with it. So, such a lovely couple, and indeed such a lovely wedding party, and I'd just like to thank the ladies for all looking themselves looking wonderful, particularly Emma, our bride here. Josh made an effort. I'd just like to move on now and just actually, we're going to have a part of the ceremony which is quite important, where what we'll do is Emma and Josh are actually going to exchange vows. From then on, we'll then go on to exchanging of the rings and a slightly Scottish celebration towards the end. So, would you like to exchange your rings?
From the moment we met, I knew there was something special about you. When we talked for hours. We laughed till my cheeks hurt. And when we kissed, you took my breath away. Today I vowed to help you love your life and the life we lead. I promise to hold you in my heart and carry you with me every day. I say this so that you can rest, knowing that your heart is safe within mine. And it will always have a home. I promise to nourish your soul with adventure, and I promise to dance with you whenever possible, from our living room to the driveway to the 400 toll to the streets of Boston. I vow to support you and pursue your dreams as if they were my own. I promise to love you for all that you are, all that you have been, and all that you are yet to be. With all my heart, I vow to never forget that this is a once-in-a-lifetime love, and I will honour it and guard it in the deepest depths of my being.
No, there's no following that, are there? Emma, my Pooh Bear, my friend, and beautiful loving companion. The promises I make today, our greatest day, is to always make you feel loved, to stand strong by you when you have been weakened or hurt, and to give you encouragement when needed, and to keep my big mouth shut when it's definitely not. I promise to be faithful and supportive. I promise all of this to be true. I give you my soul. My heart, I promise this all to you. The past 11 years, we've had more ups than downs. We've traveled the world together. We've adopted a Charlie dog together. We bought a house together. And we finally got married. together. I love you more today than I did yesterday. I love you even more tomorrow than I have today. Tomorrow, forever, always.
Beautiful.
Emma, please repeat after me. This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
In token and pledge.
Token, pledge.
Of our constant faith and abiding love.
Of our constant faith and abiding love.
Josh, would you place the ring on Emma's ring finger in the left hand? Repeat after me.
This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
Token and pledge.
Token and pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
I guess you kiss a bride again.
Finally.
Traditional part of the Scottish wedding history, we traditionally drink from the Queen party. As you say it, I'll give you best wishes. May the walls of your house never fall in. May you never fall out. Who brings you man and wife yet again?
Thank you.